I'm Corey, I'm with Nightmare Playgrounds, and this video is at the request of some people who've been asking about Cabopatch, also known as Bondo. Some people have wanted a kind of a tutorial on how to mix it and what to do with it, and some of the cautionary things you need to do, or precautions, I should say. So you're not going to see too much of my face in this one. I'm sure you're thankful about that. And I'm going to be doing most of this stuff where you can watch the process kind of hands-on. Just be aware that I'm going to have to do voiceover because while I'm doing this, I have to wear a mask. It's a particulate mask. I highly recommend doing this. Do it in a place that is either very well ventilated and have the mask on. Sometimes being outside is a little difficult because the stuff that we're going to use today is stuff called Cabo-sil, and you can actually get this at Tap Plastics and some other places, but I get mine from Tap Plastics. It's a very fine fumed silica. You can respirate it, which means that you'll breathe it into your lungs. It will stay with you until you die and even after. It can get inside of your lungs. It causes all sorts of breathing problems if you have too much of it in your lungs, but it doesn't come out. So absolutely use breathing protection when you're doing this process with the Cabo-sil. There's another way that you can do this Cabopatch or Bondo, and you just get some Prosaide medical adhesive or Prosaide adhesive. There's a bunch of different companies that make it. Some people swear by some brands, some people swear by others. So far, I haven't found too many problems with different brands. It's pretty similar. There's different types of Prosaide that you can get. There are low tack and then the tacky. Low tack is typically used when you're doing kind of like painting appliances and stuff like that, when you're mixing it with acrylics. However, the high tack is probably what you want for the Cabopatch or for the Bondo. Both, it's called the same thing. And the same thing is called both things, Cabopatch and Bondo. The nice thing about it is it dries translucent, because that's one of the inherent properties of the Prosaide, is it dries a little bit clear, which means you can tint it. So if you want to do a batch of stuff that's already tinted to kind of match skin tones and things like that, or if you're doing monster effects and you want it all to be green and you already have the green paint that you're going to be using, you can mix it all up and it'll blend really well. And it's really, really sticky. It sticks pretty well to all my actors that I've used it on. Just be advised that with any actor, their skin is going to really matter for what you do for your appliances. Obviously, if you have a real sweaty person or an oily person, stuff's going to come off a little bit easier. It's going to come off quicker. You're going to have to do a lot of application, reappliances, and patchwork. So just be advised, you're probably going to get to know the actor's skin, but I found that this stuff is really resilient. It all holds up really well, and the nice thing is it's flexible. So if you do a wound on kind of a flex point, it stays on pretty well. Now, if it's a flex point, you got to make sure that if it's like on the neck or something like that, and they're going to fold their neck at any time, you need to powder it or seal it with something, either like a green marble sealer, blue marble sealer, or a barrier spray. There's a bunch of companies out there that make different types of barrier sprays or different types of sealants. Baby powder works too, but if you're going to have it on somebody's skin and they're going to flex, it can stick to itself. It's very, very tacky. So anyway, without further ado, let me show you how to mix it. It's really simple. It's not going to take long. This probably took longer than me showing you, but we'll find out.
Okay, here we have the Prosaide adhesive. This is about an 8-ounce bottle. You can find them for different prices. They're all relatively about the same. This is Cabo-sil. It's about $10 for a container like this. This container has lasted me for quite a while. If you buy one of these containers, chances are you're going to be using it for a while. And this small container is some remnants of the Bondo Cabopatch that I have. Now, I'll use the name interchangeably. I usually call it Cabopatch or Bondo. You can see how powdery and fine the Cabo-sil is. One of the things that I've found is that I like to put the Cabo-sil into the container first. This allows it to mix up easier, and of course this is my experience. I do it this way because that way I'm not pouring the Cabo-sil on top of the prosaide and then mixing it, which puts that fine silicate up at the top of the container, and they're easier to fall out and get in the air and contaminate your workspace. By covering it with the prosaide, it actually weighs it down, and then you can mix it up. Be very careful. It does sometimes fall off the spatula. If you want to use a spoon, that's fine too. A plastic spoon would work just fine. I like using these little tongue depressors because they're convenient. And basically I just wet the Cabo-sil with the prosaide and then carefully spoon it together. I kind of fold it in on itself on the first parts when I'm mixing it, just to kind of get all the Cabo-sil tacky and wetted down so it's not floating out of the little container on me. And then basically it's just a matter of mixing it to the consistency you want. Sometimes you want it a thicker consistency, more paste-like, and sometimes you want it a little bit thinner, a little runny, so that you can do different effects with it. Depending on if you're blending appliances, if you're doing major wound buildup, if you're doing on-skin application for the different things. I also always cap the Cabo-sil as quick as I can before I make a mess of things and knock it over, because like I said, it's really hard to clean up, and once it gets in the air, I don't necessarily want to be in that environment or have my loved ones or friends in that environment either. And then I get all the stuff off the sides. The old Bondo will wake right up with the new prosaide mixed into it. It actually will make itself useful again. It doesn't have to become more tacky or less tacky. As long as it's not completely dried out, I'll usually just fold it back into the mixture and get it working with the stuff that I've put in new. And again, that's it on mixing Bondo. There's not really much to it. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Hopefully it's not too basic, and hopefully if you have any questions, you can get a hold of me. Thanks for watching. But I'm on the outside, and I'm looking in. I can see through you, see your true colors, it's inside.